Hello, everyone. Hate starting the show off on a sad note. This one has to be done. Very sad, very tragic, much too young. This guy had just started off his major league career this year with the St. Louis Cardinals. In fact, he even went to the playoffs, went to the postseason, was added to the roster. Oskar Tavares, one of the most highly touted prospects in the major leagues, sadly was killed in a car accident yesterday, October 26th, in the year of our Lord, 2014, at the much too young age of 22 years old. Folks, he was born June 19th, 1992. Passed away yesterday, him and his girlfriend. She was 18. They both passed away tragically in a car accident. No details have really been emerged as to what happened, but all I know is it's a tragedy nonetheless, and it's definitely worthy of a moment of silence for a guy whose career was cut tragically short, and hopefully it won't be forgotten. So a moment of silence, please, for the late, great Oskar Tavares. All right. Yeah, you hate to see something like that, folks. All I can say is always be very, very cautious of driving because, folks, your life could be cut like that. It is not cool. Highly uncool. So, with that said, we can have the show on a sour note. Oh, no. Not at all. Hello, everyone. It is indeed Monday.
I'm going to tell you.
October 27th in the year of our Lord 2014. How are all you doing out there? I am doing awesome as always. Wicked awesome. It's Yeehaw Blues Monday. Yeehaw. Because you know beer is good for you. You hot diggity goddamn right it is. And folks, we got a couple of unofficial sponsors for today's show. One of them, this guy has done it. It's official. He's an official sponsor of Beer and Song of the Day. He's an official business now. Netch's Pepper Company out of Minot, North Dakota. Yeah, I know, right? Well, my good friend, Lynn Russell. You go by Vern or Lynn, or both. Let me know, man. Either way, he's a badass crook dog I know from Joe Old England, and he makes his own hot sauces. I have 7 of them right now. He sends them to me for free. I pitch his product, and he pitches my taste buds. How about them apples, huh? This stuff's amazing. Spicy moly hot sauce, folks. Netch's Pepper Company, the reason why I say he's official, he officially got his license today. He is an official business now. It is no longer. Prior to then, it used to say this product has not been processed or has not been processed in a commercial kitchen. It has been home processed in a kitchen that also uses common food, allergens, whatever. But he is legit now. Previously, I said these food products have been produced in a domestic kitchen and have not been produced under inspection. Well, he passes inspection. He's a bona fide, legitimate, no-bull businessman. Lynn Vern Russell. Vern and L. Russell. My friend. My buddy. A huge love doctor salute to you. Congratulations. And I am proud and honored to continue featuring your hot sauces. Your payment to me for pitching your product with your hot sauces, my payment to you is increased sales, and that will happen. Seriously, folks, these hot sauces are so good. Now, my wife's the first American born in her family. She's Mexican. Her mother loves these hot sauces. Sarah loves these hot sauces. So when you can impress them with true, legitimate, no bull, couple of tough Mexican women, anything is possible. Vern, I'm mighty proud of you, brother. Congratulations, man. And then my good friend, our very first unofficial sponsor of Beer and Song of the Day, my good friend Krystal Lloyd of Krystal Addiction, a real stunningly gorgeous sweetheart of a lady. Oh, yeah. Facebook.com/Krystal Addiction. Folks, you need to get your butt on over to her page. Freelance model, She's an actress. She's a published poet, and she know it twice. I know her from Jolly Old England. Didn't start, because danger is no stranger to an age ranger. That's right, Krystal. And she's got it going on with a peephole. Oh, keyhole peep shows. That's it. Oh, yeah. Oh, what do we call it? It's not a strip club, folks. Jesus. Get your mind out of the gutter. No, it's a burlesque place. Yeah. And I want to give a shout out to a couple friends of hers that are now friends of mine. Oh, yeah. Bella and Chelsea King. Two lovely, gorgeous ladies that are very dear friends of my dear friend, Krystal Lloyd. Drop dead gorgeous, former real babe of the day on Beer and Song of the Day like four times. And also a former guest co-hostess on our show twice. And Bella, Chelsea, I want the two of you to know. And Krystal, you let all your friends know over at Keyhole Peep Shows. If anybody wants to be featured as a real babe of the day or real hunk of the day on Beer and Song of the Day, I say B&A. Let's make it happen, all right? I feature all kinds of hunks of the day and babes of the day. I take fan requests. That's what it's all about. So you ladies out there you go. And so Krystal, thanks for spreading the word once again. Much love to you, sweetie. From the Love Doctor to you, I give you the Love Doctor salute. With that said, I've already gone over time with my initial shout-outs, unofficial shout-outs and unofficial sponsors and official sponsors. So let's bring out the proper beer consumption apparatus for Blues Monday, a little Route 66 style. A new beer to feature on Beer and Song of the Day. Never been featured. In fact, I've never even drank this here beer before. I've had Oskar Blues Brewery before. I've had their beers. I have not had this one. Oskar Blues Ten Fidy Imperial Stout. Ten Fidy, all right. 10.50 percent alcohol by volume. That's 10.50. Ten Fidy. Alcohol by volume, strong stuff. Longmont, Colorado, the home of my man Wally Fortier, Wally's aluminum shaping process, not Wally's ass sculpting process. So he probably wouldn't mind that if he was single and she was hot. Wicked hot. But anyway, power beer winning apparatus, rough technique. I know, canned beer, right? Every so often. Canned beer is becoming more popular. Canned microbrewing, 45 degree angle, right into the big consumption apparatus, right over the keyboard. Because I'm sad, damn good, haven't spilled a drop yet, never have, never will. Deep, dark, and hopefully delicious. Look at that, folks. That's black gold, Texas tea. Ooh, yeah, deep. All right. Cheers to best all of you pussies. Say Germany goodbye as they say in Japan. Wow. That is full of flavor. There's no question about that. This is fantastic. Wally Fortier, I already know you're going to want a can of this. I will bring you a can soon, okay? Because every time I get something new, I have you try it out, okay? That's what I do. So, Wally, there you go. And friends, this one is a big solid A on the Love Doctor beer scale of awesomeness. This is awesome. All right. Well, we have got a bunch of birthdays to get to, and right off the bat, I got three of them, all born the exact same month, day, and year. How awesome is that? Totally wicked awesome. All of them are final exam graduates of the Martha's Vineyard East High School class of 1991, the best damn graduating class in the history of mankind, womankind, and that kind. First, we got Heather Smith. Heather, I've known since kindergarten. No kidding, we went to kindergarten together. We graduated together. Heather, always a pleasure chatting with you. Happy birthday to you, girl. How you doing? Hope you're doing well. Great hanging out with you on February 11, 2013 over at Wharf Restaurant and Pub, Eglintown, Massachusetts. That was a lot of fun. We even did the show there. Remember that? Oh, yes, we did. Well, Heather, happy birthday to you. And loved having you on the show as well. Great hanging out with my fellow classmates. Awesome stuff. Heather, like I didn't even need Facebook for your birthday. I've had it memorized since I met you. September 7th, 1978 when we started kindergarten. How awesome is that? Almost as awesome as you. Heather, cheers and beers to you. Happy birthday. Celebrate well and enjoy. Ah, my man, Kane Bennett. Kane Bennett, the pride of Eggertown, Massachusetts. Like I said, final standing graduate of 1991. Kane, born the exact same month and year as Heather. And Kane, happy birthday to you, brother. How you doing? Hope you're doing well. Haven't heard from you in a little bit. I'd love to hear from you. Drop me a line. Let me know how life's treating you. And hope you have a wicked awesome day. Celebrate well and enjoy. Cheers and beers. And then, my most unforgettable buddy. Why do I say that? She's a real sweetheart. I talk to her all the time. The pride of Oak Bluffs, Massachusetts. Born the exact same month, day and year as Kane and Heather is the lovely, amazing Erika Oliver. Erika, you and I were both the most unforgettable in our high school class, in Martha's Vineyard Beach High School class of 1991. Believe me, nobody ever forgets you. Nobody ever forgets me. No doubt about that. So we've always been most unforgettable buddies. Erika, you're my most unforgettable buddy, no doubt about it. Happy birthday to you, girl. You have an unforgettable birthday, like I'd forget. Come on. And hope you have a wicked awesome day. Celebrate well and enjoy, and a big cheers and beers to you. Well, I love giving birthday shout-outs to classmates. Hang on just a second, folks. I got something. Yeah. Have to be prepared for later, you know? Like Boy Scout motto, be prepared, be prepared. All right. Next birthday, my man Nick Carone. Nick Carone. A badass mamma jammer of a man who shapes metal for a living. I know him because I worked with him in jolly old England. Nick Carone, happy birthday to you. How you doing? Hope you're doing well. Haven't heard from you in a little while. Love to hear from you. This guy's so awesome. Remember Nick? Excuse me. 3.5 years ago, remember we went to Bible camp together? Oh yeah, we found God, learned lots of scripture. You know what else? We learned about adult beverages too now, didn't we? Oh yeah, we did. Well, Nick, my friend, have a wicked awesome day. Happy birthday to you. Party hard and enjoy celebrating like it's 1969 minus the awesome. Cheers and beers to you. All right, next on the list. Now here's a lovely sweetheart of an age ranger as well. Absolutely beautiful, the wonderful, always smiling Heather Pavlik. Heather, what up, girl? How you doing? Hope you're doing well. Happy birthday to you. I work with her down here in Yeehaw, Texas. That's right, otherwise known as Southern Oklahoma. I know Vern, Lynn, Russell. You hate that. But hey, you gotta bust your chops a little bit, right? Just saying. All right, well, anyway, Heather, my friend, happy birthday. Hope your day's been phenomenal, and hope you have a wicked awesome day. Celebrate well and enjoy. Hey, by golly, cheers and beers to you. Ah, next on the list, the final birthday of the day. Gotta go to a Mafiaette, Scarlet Method. M-E-T-H-O-T, Scarlet Method. Happy birthday to you, girl. How you doing? Hope you're doing well. I'll be on the old Mafia Wars right after I get done with this here show. We're gonna ice some fools. We're gonna kick ass, take names, kill commies for mommy. That's what we're gonna do. Oh, yeah. But hey, Scarlet, happy birthday. Hope you have a wicked awesome day. Celebrate well and enjoy it. Cheers and beers to you. All right, before I get to the trivia question. Uh-oh, where'd I put my notes? Oh. Finally discombobulated today. Okay, check this out. So my good friend Justin Dimmitt, yes, you know him, you love him, of Prosper, Live Long and Prosper. Look at this. His wonderful, gorgeous, exotic, better half, Robin, made this t-shirt for me. Beer and Song of the Day. Yes, no kidding. I now have an official Beer and Song of the Day t-shirt for Beer and Song of the Day. How awesome is that? Totally wicked awesome. You know what I'm saying, eh? That's what I'm telling you about. Make Chanton Geneve and French for wicked awesome. Hey, all Canada indeed. Give some love to our neighbors up north. Always throw that in there. So yeah, Robin, I'm giving you, my dear, the big love doctor salute. I love this. I appreciate it. Something that's unique about this shirt, though. Folks, note that the writing is on the right side as opposed to the left. Look at all the shirts that you've ever worn. All shirts with logos are either in the center or on the left. I guarantee it. This is the only shirt I've ever worn in my entire life where the logo is on the right side of the moob instead of the left side of the moobs, you know? Just saying. I think it's unique. I think it's different. And you know something, Robin? I abso-freaking-smurf-a-lutely love it. Hail to the effing yeah. Much respect. Robin, Justin, thank you both so much. I truly appreciate it. Beer and Song of the Day will live forever. All right. Had to get that out there. Awesome stuff. All right. So we had a trivia question, and this one did get answered, and I was impressed. Risque blues legend R. Mentor Chapman recorded under a different name. He was the true king of risque blues. What name did R. Mentor Chapman go by? Well, my good friend, C.J. Clements. Yup. That's how I feel about you, buddy. Only because I'm having to pay on your bet right now. C.J. Clements, I gotta admit, I had no idea you were such a blues fan. You said Bo Carter. Dude, that is abso-freaking-lutely correct. Wicked awesome job. Big! Love Dr. Salute to you. Oh, hell yeah! And right now you're watching the Cowboys barely beat the Redskins. Dude, they should be killing the Deadskins. They suck, man. But anyway, CJ, paying your bet right now. That's why I have that Yankees garbage on my page, on my Facebook page. I got 6 days to go on the bet, folks. Yep, I'm wearing Yankees crap on my page. At least I picked the classy stuff and no aeroid. All right, so there you have it. Great trivia question. And a great trivia answer. Well done, CJ. Well done. All right, we had a marriage a couple days ago. I didn't get a chance to mention them until just now. My good friend Jyssika Lewis, a wonderful sweetheart of a lady, cop that I know down here in Yeehaw, Texas, otherwise known as Western Louisiana. The lovely Jyssika married a wonderful man by the name of Dalton Aguilar. And yes, I saw Jyssika, you did change your name. You changed your last name to Aguilar. You are Facebook official. Dalton, Jyssika, congratulations to the two of you. Happy wedding day from October 25th. Totally wicked awesome. Hopefully you'll be married for at least 80 years. Congratulations to the two of you. I say cheers and beers. Mazel tov! Minus the breaking, of course. I would never break this. All right, speaking of weddings, 24 years ago today, October 27th, 1990, my very own awesome cousin, Wayne Whitmore. Wayne Whitmore married his wonderful better half, Kellyanne. Wayne and Kellyanne Whitmore, hard to believe, but it's true. 24 years of marriage. Jeez, Wayne, I remember when you were a kid. Oh, yeah, of course, I was a kid too. Duh. Wayne got married. He was like 20 years old when he got married. And by God, him and Kellyanne have been married for 24 years. That is truly wicked awesome. 24 down and at least 48 to go to catch our grandparents. Right, Wayne? That's right. Our grandparents married for 72 years before they passed away, 71 days apart. Wayne, you and Kellyanne have a very good shot at doing that, and I think you're going to do it. Hell yeah. Congratulations to the two of you. Happy wedding day. Happy anniversary. 24 years. And cheers and beers to the two of you. All right. Now, I do have time for some quick additional shout-outs. Yes, I do. Got to give it up for my man, John Peterson. John Peterson, no blues episode would be complete without you. I know you love them old-school blues. You're a big blues nut like I am. You fix weapons for a living. You're totally méchant, Janiel, again, French for wicked awesome. And John Peterson, the pride of Alabama, otherwise known as, that's right, Eastern Mississippi. But he works down here in Yeehaw, Texas, otherwise known as Northern Mexico. John, my man. Dude, hey, I think you don't like today's songs. I really do. So, hey, listen up and cheers the beers. And then my man, Bobby Cosme. Bobby, great picture you posted on the Beer and Song of the Day Halloween Costume Contest. Folks, get in on it. 2 days left. Oh, wait, 3 days left. I'm sorry. By the time you watch the show, it'll probably be 2 days left. You got till October 30th at 23:59 hours. 11:59 p.m. Massachusetts time, okay, to submit your picks, because I have to be able to do the show the next day. Whoever gets the most likes on their picture wins the Halloween costume contest. We got two versions. We've got animals. We've only got two pets right now, and we've got probably about 15 entries for the humans. And Bobby Cosme, you entered yours, you and your whole family, you and your wonderful better half, Amanda. You're an awesome young man as well, and wow, lots of people are liking that picture, and you've brought some friends on my page. Dude, thank you so much. Can't say you're fan of the week yet. I have not tallied up the fan of the week yet. I'm going to try to do that for tomorrow's show, but Bobby, I want to give you a shout out. just because you're absolutely freaking awesome. And hey, cheers and beers, man. Oh, yeah, can't go do beer and song of the day without my good man, Darius Cross. Badass crew dog that I work with down here in Yeehaw, Texas, otherwise known as Eastern New Mexico. Darius, you and I were talking Haagen-Dazs earlier today. We was talking some blues music, weren't we? Oh, yes. Taught you a few lessons, didn't I? Yeah, I did. Dude, you know your music. You love your music. Prepare to be entertained by some choice songs that the Love Doctor will bring to you, and you will be blown away. Oh, yeah. So Darius Cross, my man, talking about how you had to use a garbage bag as a condom and it fit in a little snug. Man, you one crazy mofo, bro. But hey, cheers and beers to you, man. Much love to you. Not in that way. Don't get emotionally wrecked. Okay. Did I get all the shout-outs? No, I did not. Danyelle Kavanaugh Fry. Another sweetheart of a lady. Danyelle, I just want to give you a shout-out. You brought some fans to the show as well, and I appreciate it. Danyelle, a real sweetheart of a lady. Former real babe of the day on Beer and Song of the Day. So I said, hey, let's give Danyelle a shout-out. Why? Because you like Smith Barney. You made it the old-fashioned way. You earned it. Danyelle, my dear, cheers and beers to you, and hope you enjoy the show. All right. There's a lot of birthdays for today. I knew I was forgetting somebody. I'm forgetting a couple. My very own great Uncle Ted. Great Uncle Ted. The youngest of the 10 kids from my grandfather. On my mother's side. My great Uncle Ted, for your daughter Tammy. Happy birthday to you, Tammy. How you doing? Hope you're doing well. Hey, distant relative, you know. And your dad, my great Uncle Ted, he says, have a glass of wine. So, hey, have a glass of wine with your dad, will ya? You ought to do it. Make it happen. In the meantime, I'll cheers and beers a glass to you on your birthday. Happy birthday, Tammy. And great Uncle Ted, I love you, man. I do. You're a totally awesome man. And my man, Stephen Lombard, Saints fan. Stephen Lombard, you called me out. I made a prediction that the Saints were going to get crushed by the Packers. Boy, that worked the other way around, didn't it? All right, Stephen Lombard, I'm sure you will probably think that I deserve this. Boy, that was a jacked up prediction. You deserve a little GFY from your buddy Steve Lombard. Stephen Lombard, yeah, man, your Saints looked awesome. They really did. Great win. Great job. Cheers and beers to you, bro. All right. It's time to get moving. Show's already gone longer than I wanted. Hey, my good friend Justin Dimmitt gave me some ideas. A little fan request for today's babe and hunk of the day. So I said, let's make it happen. I love fan requests. It's all about you, the fans. Without you, I'm as worthless as tits on a board. Perry. End of freaking story. Speaking of fans, 50 new likes in the past week. Over 30 gained since last night. Wow. Keep them coming. Keep it coming. Look. Oh, yeah. Alright, well, today's hunk of the day on Beer and Song of the Day is an absolute badass. And Darius Cross, I think he's got you beat. Because see, he's a male porn star. And he's mashing that thing. Mashing that thing, Bo Cotta, January 19, 1935. Listen to the lyrics as we show off Evan Stone. Your hunk of the day on Beer and Song of the Day for October, for Monday, October 27th, the year of our Lord, 2014. Darius Cross, John Peterson, mashing that thing. Oh, it looks like he got his chin mashed, all right. Yeah, it looks like a better looking version of Fabio. I guarantee he gets more love than two. Never get tired of mashing that thing. Bo Cotta, listen to that guitar. Why not porn stars for Babe and Hunk of the Day? We haven't done that in a long time.
I went home last night about 10:30. I wanted to mash that thing as soon as I got in. Oh, mash that
I like that picture. Sharp.
I woke up this morning about
oh, there you go, ladies. Any men that love the men.
Just before I go, oh, Mac Nassay. Oh, Mac Nassay. Doesn't ever get tired of baby Lord Mac Nassay.
I don't think Everett Stone gets tired of mashing that thing either, folks. Just saying. Real blues right here, folks. That's what I'm talking about. There you go. Yeah? That's a good picture right there. I think women should be able to be topless and it shouldn't be censored. Men have bigger boobs than women sometimes. Just saying. Celebrity birthdays for today. How about 26th President of the United States of America and one of the greatest of them all, Teddy Roosevelt, born this day in 1858, passed away at the age of 60 in 1919. Kelly Osbourne. Ah, yeah. The lovely Kelly Osbourne, of course. Ozzy Osbourne's daughter. She's 30 years old today. Wow. How about South Pacific Islands explorer, including Hawaii and Eastern Australia and New Zealand? Captain James Cook. Captain, not James T. Kirk, but James Cook. Born this day, 1728, passed away, or actually murdered in 1779 by Hawaiians at the age of 50. Ruby Dee, actress Ruby Dee, born this day, 1922, passed away earlier this year, 2014. Another one that passed away, he was also born on this day in 1922. He also passed away earlier this year in 2014. Major League Baseball Hall of Famer, Pittsburgh Pirate, Ralph Kiner. Ralph Kiner, Ruby Dee, both passed away at the age of 91. Both born October 22nd, 1922. Just saying. How about John Cleese? Oh, yeah. Who loves good old Monty Python? John Cleese, Monty Python group. He's 75 years old today. Welsh poet Dylan Thomas would be 100 years old today. Sadly, he passed away at the much too young age of 39 in 1953. Scott Weiland. Course of Stone Temple Pilots. Scott Weiland, Stone Temple Pilots, 47 years old today. Simon Le Bon of Duran Duran, 56 years old today. Andrew Bynum, basketball player, 27. Overrated quarterback Brady Quinn. There's only one Brady that's a badass in the NFL, and it ain't Brady Quinn. Tom Brady, enough said. He's 30 years old today, born the exact same month and year as Kelly Osbourne. Poet Sylvia Plath, born this day 1932, sadly committed suicide at the age of 30 in 1963. Robert Picardo, oh yeah, holographic doctor in Star Trek Voyager. Just had him as a hunk of the day on Saturday. Bob Picardo, 61 years old today. Marla Maples, 51 years old today. How about that? Nanette Fabre, actress, 94 years old today. That deserves a big Love Doctor salute right there. Late great actress Teresa Wright, born this day 1918, passed away in 2005. Stephanie Abrams, a cute little lady from the Weather Channel. Meteorologist Stephanie Abrams, 36 years old today. Yeehaw, country singer Lee Greenwood, 72 years old today. Phenomenal director. Love those 80s movies that Ivan Reitman directed. Ivan Reitman, director, 68 and doing great. K.K. Downing, Judas Priest guitarist, 63 years old today. So the age of birthdays for today, October 27th, in the year of our Lord, whatever year they were born. With that, I drink. Ooh. All right. When in doubt, whip it out. Some more hot stuff, because, you know, I gotta cool off. Yeah. I'm so hot, this stuff will cool me off. Chipotle hot sauce, really good. Spicy mole hot sauce. I mean, dude, seriously, this stuff's amazing. All right. You want hot, real hot, damn hot, wicked hot, and smoking hot? Well, oh, I can't show that one. But I could show this. Oh, yes, I can. That ain't the same girl. Here we go. How about Jaden James, porn star, hottie, goddess. Jaden James. That's J-A-Y-D-E-N James. J-A-M-E-S. Sometimes you'll find it spelled J-A-Y-M-E-S. Well, that's incorrect. Well, you know, what happens to Evan Stone and other porn stars when they have lots of sex? Well, their pencil won't write no more. Bo Carter had it figured out long before they did. Bo Carter recorded this one June 4th, 1931. My pencil won't write no more. A classic indeed. Bo Carter, definitely the king of the risque blues. Just listen to these lyrics and drool. Nice assets. That's sexy. I love that. I've always been in the pinup like that. And my good friend Krystal Lloyd does stuff like that. My dear friend Krystal Lloyd is the modern day Betty Page. That's how awesome she is. Jaden James. Hot damn. Good God. Thunder jugs. Yowza. Those piercing blue eyes. Again. Wowzers. Nice assets. Yeah. If you can't figure out the lyrics, might not be smart enough to watch Beer and the Song of the Day, just saying. Good Lord.
I hugged and I kissed her all last night. It wasn't nothing doing, my old pencil wouldn't write. Because the letter's all gone.
Wow. Letter. Letter jacket. Let her do what she wants with it.
Oh, the letter's all gone. The pencil won't write.
Ain't she sexy? I think so.
You sure can tell when a man's pencil is wrong. His mama's always tipping from home because the lead's all gone. Oh, the lead's all gone.
Remember, folks, you listen to an 83-year-old song.
The pencil won't write no more. Now, listen here, man. You ought to know. Can't write for that woman. You have to let her go because your lead's all gone.
83-year-old song, and it's ageless. That's what real blues is all about. That's some great music right there. Hey, one of the greatest days in baseball history occurred October 27, 2004. My beloved, wicked awesome Boston Red Sox beat the St. Louis Cardinals 4-0. We won our first World Series since 1918 when we beat the Chicago Cubs. Yes, it happened. On this day in 2002, Anaheim Angels won their first World Series after 42 years of being in the league as they beat the San Francisco Giants 4-3. That was a phenomenal series. On this day in 1997, boy, that's a gift from heaven, Microsoft argues it should be free from government interference. What happened 17 years later? Now the government wants to control everything. Heh, go figure. Also on this day in 1997, speaking of the U.S. government, they released a redesigned $50 bill. Good lord. On this day in 1992, more government, Tipper Gore, the wife of future Vice President Al Gore, admits to covering the clock on her VCR with black tape so she wouldn't have to watch it blink. Why do I mention that? Because we never gave a shit about Tipper Gore, and we still don't, and we don't give a shit about the flashing clock. Tipper Gore, what a douchehead. Who names a kid Tipper anyway? Jeez. On this day in 1988, E.T. E.T. phone home. That's right. 26 years ago today, E.T. released to home video. It took 6 years, but it finally released to home video. 14 million copies were pre-sold, folks. Wow. E.T. does not stand for extra testicle, okay? Just saying. On this day in 1986, one of the worst days in Boston Red Sox history, probably the worst day in Boston Red Sox history. The New York Mets beat the Boston Red Sox 4-3 I just got a text message. I hate text messages. My hometown hero Colt McCoy is starting tonight. My brother. Yeah, he's my hometown hero. My hometown is Falmouth, Massachusetts. That's where I was born. My brother. On this day, 1985. Yeah, the New York Mets beat my Red Sox in the World Series. That just sucks balls. On this day, 1985, Kansas City Royals won their first World Series ever. They beat the St. Louis Cardinals 4-3. On this day, 1982, China announces its population at 1 billion people plus. On this day, 1979, happy Independence Day to St. Vincent and Grenadines as they become independent of the United Kingdom. Congratulations, happy Independence Day. I shall drink to that. On this day, also in 1979, listen to this, folks. Voluntary Euthanasia Society publishes a How to Do It Suicide Guide. Can we, like, give one of those to every person that competes for Dumbass of the Day or whatever? You know what I'm talking about, folks. People like that need a book like that. Just saying. 50 years ago today, singers Sonny Bono and Cher, Sonny and Cher wed. Cher wore bell bottoms. Gee, that's lovely. On this day in 1950, foul. Now, in 1940, Benjamin O. Davis Sr. became the first black general in the U.S. Army. Well, his son, Benjamin O. Davis Sr., I mean Jr. rather, became the first black general in the United States Air Force. Wow! That's double awesome. On this day in 1947, You Bet Your Life with Groucho Marx premieres on ABC Radio. Came to TV 3 years later. Also on this day in 1947, WMAR-TV Channel 2 Baltimore, Maryland NBC affiliate begins broadcasting. On this day in 1925, water skis patented by Fred Waller. Way to go, Freddie. On this day in 1916, the first published reference to jazz appears. Variety magazine. On this day in 1913, listen to this one. This just shows that politicians are full of shit. President Woodrow Wilson says the United States will never attack another country. Bullshit. Hell, they attacked while he was still president. Boy, Congress has been lying to us for years. Listen to George Carlin and talk about founding of America. It was founded on bullshit. Trust me, listen to that one sometime, okay? All men are created equal, unless, you know, you're different races or you're a woman and shit like that. Yeah. Yep, America's founded on bullshit. It's proof right there. Just saying, George Carlin, rest in peace. On this day in 1880, Theodore Roosevelt marries Alice Hathaway Lee on his 22nd birthday, Teddy Roosevelt. Sadly, 4 years later, she passed away. Ugh. On this day in 1871, another crooked politician, William Macy Tweed, better known as Boss Tweed, Democratic leader of Tammany Hall, arrested after the New York Times exposed his corruption. Yup, there you have it. And finally, on this day in 1858, the very day that Teddy Roosevelt was born, R.H. Macy & Company opens their first store, 6th Avenue, New York City. Gross receipts, $1,106. Look at them nowadays. Absolutely amazing. I shall drink to all of you out there. Empty his brain cells on Avjank fan. Folks! Uh-oh, Tony Romo's hurt. Folks, you know what time it is, right? Damn right, Reverend Dr. B. Folks, it's time to make like a fetus and head out to ride, take care, wicked awesome night and day. Peace be the journey. Don't do anything I wouldn't do. Don't be a drive my spirit drink, or you might kill yourself or somebody else. I'm drinking or driving is dumb than being Yanks fan, or what's dumb than that? It's written from Puka Fest and Goober Schnitzels like Eli.
Let's get Tom Brady.
You're a freaking comedian. Manning, or men slapping women, or animal abuse, or racism, or people who watch on bets, or fake friends, or anybody that supports the fans, or is a member of the Westboro Baptist Church. Things like that are just plain stupid. And definitely deserve a big, fat, GFY. Folks, I'm out of here. I'll see y'all tomorrow. Talk to you later. Bye-bye. Bye. Bye. Well, folks, you won't have to worry about Tony Romo choking this year, because if he's hurt, maybe he won't screw December up. But don't worry, somebody else will. It's the cowgirls for you. Love you, CJ Clements. Not in that way, buddy.